Right then, let's do 20 minutes of mobility and stretch work. So we're going to start in a standing position, okay? So first exercise we're going to work on, this is also a strength as well as a mobility exercise. We're going to work on the ankles, the calves, and the arches of the feet. So I'll show you from the front first of all, and then I'll show you from the side. So feet parallel to each other, about hip distance apart. You're going to come up onto your toes, and you're going to drop down to the ground. There's a big but. Okay, so if I show you side onwards, right now watch where my body moves forward. This is what most people do, is move forwards as they lift up. I want you to try and keep your ankle directly above your ankle. That's a hip. Your hip directly above your ankle. Okay, so I want you to come up nice and straight like this and back down. Okay, up and down. So no leaning forward with the pelvis. Okay, we're going to do this for 1 minute. Let's go. Be very strict about that movement. You can hold on with both hands. And just have a little pause at the top of the movement and slowly down. We're not rushing this. So we're working the arches of the feet, we're working the calves and the ankles. Oops, I didn't press start. I'm not doing very well today, am I? I called the hip and ankle and I forgot to press start. We'll get there. Let's do 20 more seconds. I would probably do this in, well, I wouldn't probably, I'll definitely do it in front of a mirror the first time you do this, just to check, because it's quite hard to know sometimes. Sometimes you can lean backwards when you're trying to not lean forwards. I don't want you to do that either. One more. And relax. Okay, this next one, then I want you to turn the feet out for me. Okay, and you can do exactly the same thing, coming up and down, and being careful not to tip forwards. Okay, we ready? Let's go. Nice and slowly again. It's a lot harder when you keep the body nice and straight as you come up. If you do one way, you go forwards. So much easier. All right, we've got 10 seconds left. And see if you can guess the next position. And relax. Okay, and the final position then, we turn the feet in. I want you to get the big toes to touch. Okay, right, we're ready? In 3, 2, 1, go. So we're working the calves and we're working the feet in all different positions of the hip. Because when you walk and run, you don't have your feet in exactly the same position each time. So we need to be strong in all these different hip positions. So we've done internal and external rotation and the feet straight and neutral. Good. 20 more seconds. After we've done this exercise, we're going to grab 4 yoga blocks. If you don't have 4 yoga blocks, it doesn't matter. You can use a couple of bucks underneath 2 yoga blocks. You can't even do it with just 2 yoga blocks. It is a little bit better with a bit extra height and relax. Okay. It's called prone airplane. Okay. So drop down onto the ground. Let's just drop this forwards a little bit. So we're going to have 2 yoga blocks on top of each other. You could, if you only got one, do it like that. It should be all right actually, like that. It's not quite as comfy, but it's not bad. Okay, and then we're going to lie down, face down, Okay, I want you to bring your big toes in to touch, so your heels drop down to the side. I just need to move my mat because I don't want my feet on this cold floor. The blocks can go on the floor. So big toes touch together, and then you drop your heels out to the side, so your hips are in internal rotation, okay? And then we want nice straight arms out in front. We're going to make sure our wrists are onto the blocks, our thumbs are pointing upwards, you're going to curl your fingertips in, and then you literally just drop your head onto the floor, okay? And hold that position. We're going to hold it for 1 minute. Where's my timer? Okay, you ready? Let's go. I want you to draw your shoulder blades together. And if you can, just breathe in and out through the nose for me, relaxing into it. Okay, and come out of that. Now I want you to take the blocks out a little bit to the side, like you're in a position Y this time. So your arms are just slightly out. Okay, we're ready? Exactly the same thing. Let's go. Drop your head down to the mat. Squeeze your shoulder blades together and just relax into it. We're here for 1 minute. Big toes are touching, heels dropping out to the side. Yeah, relax. Okay, cool. Right, now take the yoga blocks out to a T position. So your arms are going to go directly out to the side, okay? Just take a second to set up. Okay, again, curl your fingertips in. Thumbs are pointing up, arms are straight. We're here for 90 seconds this time, okay? In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Squeeze your shoulder blades together for me. Yeah. Relax the feet down to the side, big toes touching. Keep the thumbs pointing upwards. Keep squeezing the shoulder blades together. We've got 30 seconds left. And then relax, come out of that. Good. Okay, good stuff. Right, we're going to do runner's assisted stretch. We're going to stretch through the hamstrings. I want you to use a chair for this for me. If you've done this with me in classes and you've done the 3 different levels and you want to use yoga blocks, you can, but I'm going to use the chair in this session today. So what we're going to do if you bring your left foot up next to the chair, knee bent 90 degrees, okay? And then I want you to bring your back heel in line. I might just move the chair a little bit, it's not enough room. Your left, right knee in line with your left heel, okay? And then from this position here, hands on the chair, we're gonna stand up, okay? So stand up, drive your heel for me, both heels into the ground, but don't force them. If they go, great, but don't force them, okay? Straighten both legs, both feet are pointing forwards, and I want you to tense your quads in front of your thighs, okay? And that's it. We stay here for 2 minutes. You're going to breathe in and out through the nose. You're going to keep constant tension on the quads. That will help to relax the hamstrings. You're probably going to feel it on a hamstring on the front leg, possibly on the back leg, the calves on both legs maybe. Depends on your flexibility. If you can't get both legs straight, don't worry about it. You can build it up. You can put a cushion onto the chair or a couple of yoga blocks. That might enable you to get that front leg straight. As long as you can feel the stretch down the back line of the body, all's good. Just hang here for another minute. Keep breathing in and out through the nose, nice and relaxed. Keep squeezing your quads. Keep saying that because it's easy to forget and just let them relax off, but just keep squeezing for me. Any more seconds? And then gently relax down. Okay, right, let's change sides. So right leg now at 90 degrees, bring the left knee in line with your heel. Are we ready? In 3, 2, 1, let's go up. Make sure both feet are pointing directly forwards, not off at an angle. Normally it's the back leg that likes to drift off at an angle, so just keep an eye on it. Squeeze your quads for me. Good. And hopefully both legs are straight and both heels are down. But again, we don't force it if they're not. We're here for another 90 seconds. Now, how does this side compare to the other side? Well, it actually feels pretty even. It's a miracle. Keep tensing the quads. Normally, well, most of the time, my left hamstring and left calf is tighter, but today it's not. We're even. Woo-hoo. All right, we've got another minute left. Breathe in and out through the nose. If you're finding this particularly stressful and hard, try breathing in through the nose for 4 and breathing out through the mouth for 8. And then just really try to relax on that out-breath at the same time as keeping the tension in your quads for me. Ten more seconds. And gently relax out. Good work. Okay, good. All right then, down onto our butts. Okay, we're just gonna do a glute stretch. So if we lie nice and straight, okay, Bring your, using your right hand, grab your left knee. Now pulling towards your chest and then just across the body, okay? Now as if you're pulling over towards your right shoulder a little bit. You should feel a really nice stretch through your glute. Now holding here for another 50 seconds, just keep breathing in and out through your nose for me. Twenty more seconds and we'll change sides. And relax. Okay, let's change sides now. Left hand, right knee, coming across towards your left shoulder a little bit. Find that stretch and hold. I actually feel pretty even on this stretch as well. What is happening this morning? Whose body is this? Ten more seconds. And just relax out of that for me. Okay, right. Flipping over onto your knees, you need one yoga block. We're going to do 10 hip flexor releases, and then we're going to hold the hip flexor stretch for 1 minute. So pop a knee under the block, and you want your toes on the same leg that the knee is on the block, okay? So you're onto your toes on the back foot. The other foot is pointing forwards, hands on hips, okay? And then we're just gonna sink forwards and backwards for 10. And then on the 10th one, just hold into that stretch for me. Okay, I'm gonna start the timer now, so you can just hold here. So you can, if you need to, just grab a chair or something to hold on to. Otherwise, just kind of just rest gently on the front leg. We're not putting any pressure on the front leg. Should feel a nice stretch into the hip flexor. Breathe in for 4 through the nose, out for 8 through the mouth. Just really relax into it. 30 more seconds. Gently. Okay, let's switch sides. Okay, hands on your hips for me. Sit forwards. Stay nice and upright. If anything, just lean back a tiny bit. Don't lean forwards as you kind of dip forwards. Not sure dip's the right word, but it'll do. You know what I mean. All right, hold that. And again, see how you feel this side compared to the other side. minutes. It's going to have to be the last stretch because we're running out of time. 20 minutes goes so quick. 30 more seconds and then we're done. So stretch glutes, hamstrings, hips, pretty important. And we've done a little bit of ankle mobility and ankle strength work. So all good stuff. Oh, and thoracic spine as well with the pronator thing. All right, and relax. Come out of that for me. All right, nice work. Hope you enjoyed that. All right, have a good week, good weekend. Cheers.